Hi, I'm Kevin Hogan, president of Rockout Auction Company, and welcome to our upcoming November 30th, December 1st and 2nd Premier Firearm Sale, our last Premier Auction of 2018. We've had a great year, and we're going to end as strong as we started, ladies and gentlemen. As usual, we bring you some of the most important collections, some of the most important individual guns from every genre, from every respect, of military to 19th century American to sporting arms to class 3 weapons. This sale is going to be truly, truly special. One of the areas that it really stands out is Winchesters, and we've sold some remarkable stuff, particularly in the last several years, especially when you start mentioning names like the Robert M. Lee collection, of course, Robert Brotherton collection, and then some of the stuff that we have here. We can talk about the introduction of the Larry Jones collection, and so many more. So I'm going to be repetitive. I'm going to come 100 miles an hour on this video because we have so many great Winchesters, and we're going to be repetitive in the videos that we do because we have some really unique, unbelievable opportunities to mix and match not only evolutionary mixes of certain manufacturers to see some of the rarest specimens known, but we also have a unique opportunity to examine, as I've mentioned in a few other videos, you know, 19th century firearms and their competitors. You know, who did Winchester compete with? Marlin, Savage, Evans, Sharps, Spencer, so many more, Peabody. I mean, you can go on and on and on. I started, hey, I'm gonna do a Winchester video, and we started on one side, and then this is what we came up with. But there's gonna be plenty more, and because there's so much more to talk about. So if I miss something, if you say, hey, you should have done a deeper dive on that, hopefully we will, or I have, or we will. Starting on the right-hand side, kind of a conflict here. You have 66s versus everything else. Brass versus case hardening. Let's start with, again, one of the rarest specimens that a Winchester collector can hope to encounter, a Briggs Patent Henry. Of course, the first development after the Henry rifle was to fix its flaws, and here we go. So you have the head scratching, how are we gonna, you know, we need to do a better loading mechanism, we need to enclose the magazine tube, and that's what they did. And this comes out of the Robert M. Lee collection. It's a spectacular gun, tons of original blue, notice the exhibition wood. Like I said, I'm not gonna spend a lot of time on these. Right underneath it, the finest 1866 flat side carbine. This gun also has exhibition wood. It's courtesy of the Dick Hammer collection. When I say it's the finest, you can quickly see why. Notice the tremendous amount of original blue on the barrel. It's a Henry marked gun. I believe it's in the 15,000 range. And so they numbered these right in sequence with Henry rifles. And so, I mean, you think they say they made 15,000 Henry rifles, whether they did or they didn't. It is right in that range. I mean, 15,000. But look at the niter blue on the loading gate. Look at the side plates. Presentation wood, again, from the Dick Hammer collection. Right underneath it, 28 inch 1866. Again, look at the exhibition wood. And so three variations, three students' guns, but three of the best examples you could hope to find. Right underneath it, obviously, the only embellished gun on the table, also an 1866. I'm not going to pick it up, but what makes that gun special, again, Henry Patent barrel, so you know it's early. It's in the 19,000 range. So again, not short thereafter Henry rifles, but what you'll notice is that it's Samuel Hoxson factory engraved. Of course, Samuel Hoxson's very famous for engraving Henry rifles, and for a very short period of time, you'll see his work on 1866s. This is probably the best example of that small niche known of the Hoxson engraved 66s. Find a better one, and again, to tie it all together, exhibition wood, exhibition stock. I'll mention these two, a good parody of one another. Number one, Volcanics. They both have condition. One, of course, silver plated, factory engraved, ivory grips. But again, notice the condition. Notice that high polish, original blue on both barrels. But then on the brass frame, number one gun, this gun comes right out of the Oliver Winchester family. We have several letters of affidavit that go with it, as explaining how the gun was passed down through the family. It is absolutely fresh. Never before seen, never before known, and it's got the same high polish original blue that just flaked, but it came right out of the Winchester family, to bring it full circle. On this side, I'm better off shutting up, smiling, and just letting the camera work, because holy case hardening. That's what we're trying to show. And this Winchester grouping, not just on this table, but in this auction, has depth. Find a better table of case-hardened guns. We've done a lot of great Winchester videos and got to see some stuff, but holy smokes, what a lineup. I'll start at the top, and again, we're going to get into more of this. The Larry Jones collection, 1885 high wall, extremely special order with the palm rest. You'll notice it's factory engraved on the lever. A cheek piece, which you can't see, shoots in butt, globe front. It's this thing has it all with the condition to boot. Right underneath it, formerly of the Mac McCroskey collection, Winchester 1886. It's a 30-inch gun, letters to an absolute T. It is brand new, and it's a semi-deluxe. Probably the finest case-hardened 1886 that we've ever cataloged. It's got, again, it's got a great pedigree. It was sold to Mr. McCroskey by Tom Lewis, and there it went. But a 30-inch special order gun that is stone cold mint. Right underneath it, we have the 1887 lever action case-hardened deluxe. It's crispy, crunchy, brand new, beautiful. Again, they look so good. I got a great view of them. It's a 10 gauge. It's an 87, but it's a 10 gauge. It's not a 1901. It's an 1887. Deluxe, they're saying it's the first 10 gauge produced by Winchester, and it predates the 1901s big time. Then right underneath it, classic, iconic, 45-75, 1876 deluxe Tiger gun. That is just brilliant. This is just the start, and it doesn't take you long to realize the depth and the breadth of this Winchester grouping. And Winchesters are only the start. Colts, percussion Colts, cartridge Colts, Savages, Marlins. Again, we're barely scratching the surface what's available come November 30th, December 1st and 2nd at Rock Island Auction Company's last premier sale of 2018. If you've never been to one of our sales, couldn't encourage you enough to come check it out. It's a wonderful time of year around here in Illinois, the beginning of December, and we make these events a lot of fun. We really go above and beyond to try and make these an event to make it fun. Our preview day is November 29th. We do a live public preview in the evening. We bring in a band, we bring in a bar, we have great guns. What more can you ask for? So for more information on Rock Island Auction Company, check out our website, www.rockislandauction.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hope to see you in December.